Identify the marked region. What is its clinical importance? Hello and welcome to the Air Anatomy channel. Today we will learn about the supramiatal triangle or the Macewen's triangle. This is an illustration of the lateral view of the right temporal bone, and the external auditory meatus is shown as black, which is an important landmark. You can see here the squamous part, the mastoid part, the styloid and the tympanic parts. Above and posterior to the external auditory meatus, you can see the supramastoid crest indicated by this red line. This point is almost faintly palpable when you palpate a bone specimen. This is the first border of the Macewen's triangle or the supramiatal triangle. The next border is the posterior superior margin of the external auditory meatus. And the third border is the tangent to the posterior border of the external auditory meatus. So the second and third borders are very close to the external auditory meatus. The area bounded by these three lines is known as the Macewen's triangle. Now, why is this triangle so important? This triangle corresponds to the mastoid antrum. In an adult, if you drill 12 to 15 millimeters deep to this point, you will reach the mastoid antrum. So it is a landmark and a safe corridor to approach in cortical mastoidectomy. Now, what's so particular about these three borders that we mentioned? Above the supramastoid crest, that is the location of the middle cranial fossa. Actually, the dural plate will reflect at this point. So going below it, you are at least risk to enter into the middle cranial fossa and cause an meningeal injury. Now, the posterior superior margin is corresponding to the track of the facial nerve. So if you remain posterior and superior to this border, then you are at least risk to injure the facial nerve. There is also one more important landmark present here, and that is known as the spine of Henle, also known as the supramiatal spine. Both of these are indicators of the facial nerve. The third border was the tangent to the posterior border of the external auditory meatus, and that prevents us from invading into the sigmoid sinus, which is lying posterior to it. So these three borders are kind of preventing us from entering or invading or injuring more important structures nearby and safely entering into the mastoid antrum without causing any injury to the nearby structures. Now, the mastoid antrum or this Macewen's triangle also corresponds to this surface landmark, and this point is called as a simba concha, which is kind of understandable because this is the external auditory meatus. Now, above and posterior to it, you can think that there will be these three borders which corresponds to the simba conga in between it, which corresponds to the mastoid antrum. So if you have a simba conga tenderness in a patient, that means that that is an indicator that there can be mastoid antral tenderness. Thank you so much for your patient listening.